Let's talk about longitudinal waves. Longitudinal waves, when they travel in air, create areas of high pressure and low pressure. So sometimes they're also called pressure waves. Let's just take the equation of the pressure wave. So it's given as P equal to P naught cos kx minus omega t. Here P naught is the pressure amplitude, k is the angular wave number, omega is the angular frequency. Let's take an example of a pressure wave. So let's take this example. P is equal to 1 minus 1 cos 6x minus 4t. The units are of atmospheric pressure. So let's say we have to find out about the pressure amplitude. If you notice the equation, we have 1 minus cos 6x minus 4t. If you draw the graph of this equation, the wave, it oscillates about 1 and not about 0. It's because of the 1 minus in the starting of the equation. So it goes to 2, then 1, then 0. Now we have to find the amplitude. If you know, the amplitude is the maximum deviation from the equilibrium. Even though for our case the maximum pressure is 2 atm, but the amplitude will be the deviation from the equilibrium, that is 1. So amplitude will be 2 minus 1 equal to 1 atm. So now, what is the wave number of our equation? Wave number is given by k, and if you see, for our equation k is equal to 6. So the wave number is simply 6 radians per meter. So we have the amplitude and wave number for our equation. Let's find out the frequency of our pressure wave. So frequency, as you know, is given by 1 over t, where capital T is the time period. Time period depends on omega as 2 pi by omega. So we can write frequency as omega upon 2 pi. And if you look at our equation, omega in our equation is given by 4. So our frequency becomes 0.64 per second, or 0.64 hertz. Let's find out by what speed is our wave traveling. So speed of the wave is given by amplitude into frequency, that is lambda into f. Lambda, it depends on the wave number, and we previously calculated the wave number to be 6. So we know our wavelength is 1.04 meters. So just putting the wavelength and the value for frequency, we find that our velocity is equal to 0.67 meters per second. So we so far have been working with the pressure wave. Let us find out the corresponding equation for spatial deviation, that is the displacement equation for the particles through which the pressure wave was traveling. So let's call it S. Let's look at our pressure wave. So it's given by this equation. If you know, if our pressure wave is a cosine wave, our spatial wave is 90 degree out of phase to the pressure wave. So if a pressure wave is a cosine wave, our displacement wave will be a sine wave because of the 90 degree phase shift. So if this is our pressure wave, which is a cosine wave, our spatial wave will be given by a sine wave like this. So which is 90 degree out of phase. So let's write a sine wave equation for our displacement wave, which A is the amplitude, K is the wave number, omega is the angular frequency. The angular wave number and the angular frequency will remain the same as the pressure wave, but the amplitude will depend. So the K will end up, and omega will be the same as before. And let's say our amplitude to be 2 centimeters, so we'll write it in SI units, 0.02 meters. So we get the final equation for a spatial wave to be SXT equal to 0.02 sine 6x minus 4t, where 6 is the wave number as before, 4 is the angular frequency as before, and 0.02 is the amplitude.